Dear friends, welcome back to Spring Boot video session 2. In this session, we are going to explore how Spring Framework is useful, what is the difference between Spring Framework and Spring Boot, then what are the advantages where you exist in the Spring Framework. As you know already, the core part of Spring Framework is dependency injection and IOC container. IOC container is a container where all job in class is managed, all job in class lifecycle is managed. Developer don't have to control your Java classes. Spring Framework controlling your Java classes through IOC container. Spring Framework provides loose coupling code. Loose coupling code meaning if you write any code, if you write any method and you lose that method so many places in your project. Whenever you change the method implementation or method signature, whatever you are going to change, then you need to change wherever you are using this particular method. That is a tightly coupled. I want to avoid this kind of problem. I don't want to face this kind of problem. In this case, you can go with a loose coupling code. That loose coupling features supported by Spring Framework. Also, using loose coupling code, we can write our unit test very effectively. If you write a piece of code, I want to test that particular code. You can do that in Spring Framework very effectively using loosely coupling code. And Spring Framework is a configuration based. In legacy Java project, if you are not using a Spring Framework in your project, if you want to do any configuration, for example, I want to do logging mechanism, I want to do database connectivity, I want to manage database transaction. For these kind of activities, we have to write certain code. These codes are not part of your business functionality. This is not part of your business functionality. For example, if you want to achieve any database connection, you have to write some code. This kind of non-business related code we can avoid using Spring Framework. This code we'll call it as a boilerplate code. We can reduce lot of boilerplate code using Spring Framework. Through this, developer can save their time. Developer can focus only their business logic. Spring Framework is a easily pluggable IDE. That is what I mean is, for example, if you want to integrate Struts framework, if you want to integrate JSF, Struts is one of the presentation layer view part. If you want to integrate this particular framework into the Spring Framework, we can integrate. I want to use JSF, Java Server Faces. Java Server Faces is one of the presentation layer provided by Sun Microsystem, that is Oracle. Okay, if you want to integrate that JSF in a Spring Framework, we can easily integrate it. If you don't want to use JSF, we can plug out, we can plug in some other view layer. Similarly, Hibernate, Hibatis, there are many persistent framework. Persistent framework nothing but data manipulation layer, insert, update, delete, this kind of activities we can do by through persistent layer. The popular persistent layers are Hibernate, Hibatis. I want to integrate Hibernate inside a Spring Framework, you can integrate it. No, I don't want Hibernate, I need Hibatis, means you can unplug the Hibernate, you can easily plug the Hibatis. This kind of feature is good for Spring Framework. Spring Framework supports this kind of feature. Easily we can plug particular library, we can plug out the libraries. And another one is Spring MVC. Spring MVC is a part of Spring Framework. Using Spring MVC, we can develop the presentation layer very effectively. The Spring Framework provides dispatcher servlet, model and view, view resolver. If you want to create any presentation, if you want to develop any presentation layer, in the case of Java legacy method, you have to go with servlet. Without servlet, we cannot write a presentation layer. or without JSP we cannot run, you cannot write presentation layer. We need to go with help of either servlet or JSP. Okay, but in the case of Spring MVC, MVC provide one servlet called dispatcher servlet. Using that dispatcher servlet, you can integrate your presentation layer very effectively. This dispatcher servlet uses model and view and the view resolver. What is model and view? Model and view is nothing but whenever request and response is happening. Okay, what is request and response? When you say request, data is sending to server. When you say response, data coming from the server. This particular management, the request response management happened by dispatcher servlet. Models holds the data. Views is the layer where you want to display the data coming from the model. Okay, these things handled by dispatcher servlet. Then view resolver. Using view resolver, you can tell which kind of view you want to use. I can tell to the Spring framework, I want to use this kind of view. For example, I want to use JSP. You can tell Spring MVC through view resolver, I want to use JSP. Or I don't want to use JSP, you can go with some other views like velocity. I want to use velocity as a view. In such a case, you can tell to the Spring MVC, I want to use velocity. That particular a task achieved by view resolver. In the view resolver, you can tell which type of view you want to use. So these things are all configurable only. We don't have to write any code. Okay. This is the advantages of Spring framework. Welcome back. This session we're going to talk about why Spring Boot. Spring framework already have a lot of feature. Why again they are launched Spring Boot? As you know already, Spring framework reduces a lot of boilerplate code like connecting database, configuring views, configuring your MVC project, that is views on the dispatcher servlet, etc., etc. You don't have to write any single code. Through configuration you can achieve. Now Spring Boot going to one step ahead. It eliminates configuration task also. If some people directly working with Spring Boot, they don't know really value of Spring Boot. They don't realize the value of the Spring Boot. If some people already work with Spring framework, they are now want to learn Spring Boot, they definitely they realize that what is the value of Spring Boot. Okay. For example, here I want to create a simple MVC application, web MVC application, Spring MVC application. For that, I need to configure dispatcher servlet. I want to configure view resolver. Okay, if in the case of Spring framework. But if you're using Spring Boot, you don't have to configure dispatcher servlet. You don't have to configure view resolver. That configuration done by automatically Spring Boot. There is one feature called auto configuration feature in Spring Boot. Through that, auto configuration happening in a Spring Boot. In my experience, when I work with a Spring framework, if you want to create one small web MVC, Spring MVC application, for that, I have to create an XML file. In that XML file, I want to configure dispatcher servlet. I want to tell what is a view. I want to tell what is the view I want to use through view resolver. So this configuration I need to tell, then only I can successfully launch one simple web MVC application, Spring MVC application. If you don't know the configuration, definitely you cannot. Sometime if you made a small mistake, we cannot configure. It will take a lot of time. Okay, so configuration side we have some drawbacks. If you added proper jar files, then only your configuration work properly. Otherwise, it will not work. You need to find out the root cause, then you need to fix it. This is a time consuming task. Spring framework is a good feature, but configuration side we are having this particular drawback. Lot of developer will spend lot of time to configure database, to configure transaction management, to configure MVC. To avoid this problem, Spring Boot is coming to the picture. Okay, Spring Boot will do auto configure. We will do the auto configure for you. How it is auto configure is happening? We'll going to see shortly that now. How does the auto configure is happening in Spring Boot? When you start the Spring Boot application, it will check if any jar file exists. For example, if MySQL jar file exists, it will do the MySQL connection configuration. If the WebMEC jar is present in the Spring Boot class path, automatically the Spring Boot configure dispatcher server, vResolver, everything for you. There is some default configuration, the configuration done by your Spring Boot application. Okay, who will go to add this jar file? Okay, we should know, right? If you want to configure Spring MEC, you want to add some jar files. Okay, who will go to add the jar file? That jar file added by your Spring Boot starter project. Spring Boot provide lot of starter project. There are many starter project. Each starter project downloads the jar file from the repository, and after downloading those jar file, these jar files exist in the Spring Boot class path. When you start the Spring Boot application, your Spring Boot application read the jar file. According to the jar file availability, it will do the auto configuration. Now we'll check with the Spring Boot starter. Here I have given three different starter projects: Spring Boot starter, data JPL. If you provide Spring Boot starter data JPL, it will do the database connection automatically. Spring Boot starter AMQP, that is messaging server, RabbitMQ messaging server. I want to enable RabbitMQ in my Spring Boot application. If you give this startup project, automatically your RabbitMQ configure. You don't have to do anything. It will automatically configure by Spring Boot. Then Spring Boot starter web. If you add Spring Boot starter web, your Spring Boot project pull all jar files that needed to create a Spring MEC and do the auto configuration. Like what is the configuration needed for a Spring Web dispatcher server vResolver? This thing done by your Spring Boot application. Let's see here. Okay, here this is a very simple Spring Boot application I have created. Okay, I don't want to explain all the stuff in this project now. I'll go to explain next video only. Here I want to explain something about the how the auto configuration happening. When you create a Spring Boot application, there is one file called POM file. What is stand for POM? Project Object Model. Project Object Model. Okay. This project object model XML file contain all jar file that needed for your project. Okay. In this project, I have added only Spring Boot started web. In this case, I added only Spring Boot started web. Okay. If it is a Spring framework, I don't want to add this particular dependency. In the case of Spring framework, what you have to do, if you want to achieve any web application, there are list of dependency you need to add in this POM file. Okay, there are a list of dependency you need to add in the POM file, but you don't have to add those files here. Once you added this Spring Boot started web, automatically your Spring Boot application pull those jar file in your Spring Boot class path. Okay, I think you understand. If you want to create any web application using Spring framework, there are some jar dependency needed, right? The jar you need to mention as a dependency here. But in the case of Spring Boot, you don't have to add those dependency here. Instead, you need to add only this particular dependency. Once you add this particular dependency, once you build your application, this particular started web dependency pull all jar file that needed for Spring MEC, that jar file available in your Spring Boot class path. when I build, how do you build? Say I am going to say install that will clean and build your Spring Boot application. Okay, once build is successful, there is a one folder will create, that is called target folder. The target folder will have all compilation version of your project. Okay, we don't have to worry about that now. There is a external library. Yeah, there is a external library. When you look at the external library, there is a many jar will get downloaded here. Spring Framework MVC, Spring Framework Web, and the Spring Framework Core, Context, Bean, AOP. There are many jar files get downloaded and put it in your class path. When you start the Spring Boot application, how do you start here? I'll go and start. When you start your Spring Boot application, your Spring Boot application is going to read here. It is going to read everything. Okay, there is a web MVC jar is present, so it will automatically configure the your dispatcher server, automatically configure the view resolver. Yeah, through this way your Spring Boot doing the auto configuration. See, Spring Boot Tomcat started at 8.0.0, your Spring Boot application started, your Spring MVC application is ready now. It's a very, very easy setting of the project. You don't have to do any configuration in the case of Spring Boot. Okay, the configuration automatically done by your Spring Boot application through auto configuration. Okay, if you want to tell very simply difference between the Spring Framework and the Spring Boot, if you want to prepare a coffee, what do you need? Milk, sugar powder and a coffee powder. This thing you need, these materials you need to prepare a coffee, then only you can prepare a coffee. Okay, otherwise you cannot. This is called a Spring Framework. What is a Spring Boot? You don't have to worry about these materials. Okay, Spring Boot is like a vending machine, coffee vending machine. You have to go and click the button, that's it, you will get the cup of coffee. You don't have to worry about the materials to prepare a coffee. In a single click you will have your coffee. That is called a Spring Boot. Okay, that is the beauty of Spring Boot. Spring Boot ideally uses a Spring Framework. I cannot say Spring Framework, Spring Boot is a different technology. Spring Boot uses the Spring Framework features only. They are making, Spring Boot makes developer life easy, that's it. Okay, we're going to see more things about the Spring Boot in the next video about how the auto configuration and other stuff. Okay, until then, bye bye from Firoz Keshavan. If you like this video, please share with your friends and colleagues who want to learn Spring Boot and the Spring Cloud microservice. Please share this video, this channel to your friends and colleagues. Thank you.